All right, so we're gonna do some more 20 minutes till dawn. We're gonna continue on with the kind of build we were going last time. We were doing Luna with the magic bow that we have had just unlocked. We don't have quite enough of these this currency. I don't know what currency is called, but we don't have quite enough of it to unlock anything else, so we're just gonna go ahead and start here. Darkness 7. I was doing the temple. I think the temple is hard, but let's give it a go. I think the build itself was actually working out decently. Just didn't quite make it there last time. We were having a lot of success for a while until we weren't. Now, Frost Mage, reload rate, fire rate. I think Frost Mage. The reason I think Frost Mage, other than I normally get it and it's really good, Shatter with this black hole seems really strong when we can finally get that later. Gotta be careful. Again, like I said from the last time, we are happy to stop shooting to move around because we do get the benefit of the black hole when we reload. It's not when I empty my entire clip, it's when I reload. So I can reload early and it spawns. Which, because I get that benefit, it... Okay, well, that was just really stupid of me to walk that way. But because I get that benefit, I can walk around a little more. Yeah, I'm fine with double shot. Careful. There's a lot of experience to grab there. Fire rate and ammo, bullet speed, sure. I think these are good things. I immediately lost that health. I'm not exactly happy about being so close to the wall. Let me try to change my situation here. It's just the black hole has kind of also kind of pulled me over there gravitationally as well in a funny way. We go Electromage. When you think about it, well, I need to stop getting hit in dumb ways like that. When you think about it, Electromage is going to be really good for explosions as well, because if you get the combo fire plus electric that explodes, really good. Energized, I'm not too keen on here. We can do some dark arts. Thing with energized is I'm perfectly fine with reloading, so it's kind of... I mean, it's obviously not a bad upgrade because I can already reload whenever I want, but... benefit isn't quite as large as it would be in other situations. It's really hard to avoid all of these when I have to get through all of the big guys. This might be an unsuccessful run here. I'm fine with Smite as well. I wish the black hole lasted a little bit longer. It's kind of stopping too early. Ice Shard, I could go Holy Shield as well, but... we just need one more level, and then we get another healing. But that might be really tough. Okay. We're off to a horrible start. Off to a terrible, terrible start. I'm taking way too much damage. Alright, let's try this again. Let's be focused. Get the job done. Nice. Okay, don't start pushing me to the wall again. I think that was one of the biggest problems. I was too willing to follow the black hole, even if it put me in a bad position there. Again. Frost Mage. I don't think that was any problem for me. I think Frost Mage was one of the better parts of that last time. If anything, my build had no problem. It wasn't the build, it was my play. I was getting hit like an idiot in way too many circumstances. That's good. Careful. Yeah, Electromage again. Wait, does it just go max range from my cursor? Wait, I think it does. Am I controlling the black hole? Oh my gosh, am I an idiot? Yeah, I'm an idiot. I didn't realize it just goes max range from my cursor. I can put the black hole wherever I want it. Well, don't I feel dumb? Alright. I really don't know what I want here. I guess I'll go Electrobug. I thought it was random this whole time. And give me double shot. So like I can place it near the other experience so that I can walk towards the experience. I can also go reload rate and fire rate. I wanted to let go sooner there. This is tough with the bombs. I gotta be better. It's really hard to dodge these. I don't know what I should do to do it. I also keep dying before I get to level 10. What's going on? The temple's just tough. That's really what it comes down to. It's so big. How am I supposed to do this? Oh my gosh. I want to keep going because I think I can make it work. I think I can make it work. If it keeps being bad, I can switch maps, but it has potential still. Now that I know I can control my black hole, I can probably be a little bit better early on here. Like that. Let's go fire rate. Careful. Careful, careful, careful. Double shot, yeah. Maybe I'm overvaluing Frost Mage early on. I think it'll be good later, but maybe early on it doesn't need to be too big of a focus for me. Because I'm mostly doing it for Shatter, which of course I don't start with Shatter, you get it later. I'm kind of forced him away from me a bit. Yeah, give me more of this. See, the level 5 healing is almost never that useful. I'm not normally getting hit before that point. The level 10 is usually useful, but I don't get there in time. Got potential here. Yeah, I'll take Pyromage for that potential synergy in the future here. I'll go Dark Arts. What? How am I supposed to dodge this? It's so tough. See, this is where I fall apart. I don't know how to deal with these enemies. They're too fast. I guess I should get some move speed myself. I think that was part of it. I think that's one of the big things I forgot was this darkness level makes them faster, and I need to have move speed to compensate for that. So that's it's an earlier upgrade that I need to get, and I shouldn't have taken the 2 hearts of damage if I remember that part of it. Just kind of autopiloted, started the run without even kind of thinking about that aspect. See, like, now that I got a little bit of movement speed, it feels a lot better. I can go ahead and get some of this. Dodge is probably also like a good idea. Hopefully we can make up for me taking dumb damage by getting some, or getting to level 10 here and getting some healing from it. I think Frostbite is maybe good. Like all 4 of these are really good here. I think Frostbite first to hopefully focus on the boss a bit. How am I supposed to avoid all of this? Well, I did it. Somehow. Yeah, so we go dodge because of the later upgrades mostly. I mean, dodge is also very good, and the later upgrades are going to make it even better, but we get some move speed with it later on. Now the black hole's serving more as protection than, like, trying to specifically kill enemies inside of it, I feel. It's kind of working out a little bit better that way. What do I think is the best for me here? Because I think all of these are good. I'll go ahead and get soul hearts. I don't mind going a little defensively. Usually I've been going like super offense lately. But the defensive runs I just end up getting a whole bunch of soul hearts have also been good, so I want to give it a chance at the very least. See, we're able to dodge these now finally, and that's one of the biggest things that's going to improve our success. Okay, well, that guy was just an asshole. I don't know what to say about that. so many explosions. But I'm gonna try to get some of the experience. Now I have to deal with this guy. This is why we get Frostbite, because it's gonna be annoying to deal with for sure. And if nothing else, I will kill him. Well, I don't know if it's 1% of current HP or total HP of the boss. If it's total, then well, you only have to freeze him 100 times and then he'll eventually die. Yes, Shatter is what I want for sure here. Careful. See, more explosions. Perfect. Careful against him again. The hardest part about it is that there's all these projectiles flying at the same time. The actual boss isn't really a big deal. I have enough movement speed to deal with them. It'll start being a big deal if darkness level starts increasing the boss's movement speed. Then I would need even more, but fine for now. Well, that was really hard to get a good path out of that one, but normally it's fine. I'll get there in a second. Give me that nimble. Lucky dodges. It's really hard to get out of this situation without dodge. Dodge saved me so many hits there. Move speed, elements, fire rate, triple, base, max ammo. Honestly, I think this is fine. Even though it gives me less black holes, I think it works out fine. Oh god, this spread though. I need more projectiles. Okay, maybe this was really bad. This doesn't work too well when you have so few projectiles. I need some levels here, or I'm going to suffer big time. The shatters are definitely nice. Okay, this is a start. We just want to also get the explosions with the Electromage, like combo with Burn. Lightning strikes giving explosions on burn is very strong potentially on this build. I want some defense type things probably. Yeah. It's either dodge or max HP. Let's go dodge more. Definitely partial to that with our current situation where I find it really hard to not get hit, especially with the smaller character size. Like, how did I not just get hit like a million times there? How do I deal with this situation at all? Like, I'm just having to hope. It's all hope. It's all hope that the dodges will actually trigger. I don't know how I'm making this work right now. Give me Fireball. I can't even like aim at anything specifically, really, because the spread's ridiculous. I mean, I guess I could be better and do it, but still. I just don't see how that helps all that much. I pretty much never get siege. But I don't think I want it. Ooh, this gets less spread. I think that helps a little bit here. Okay, there was not a whole lot I could do against that guy. I think we go run and gun. Now we're starting to feel better. It's all coming together now. Let me go power shot. I'm so small and stand right inside everything. Piercing will be good, yeah. Definitely. Definitely good here. It's hard for them to hit me at all, and even when they do, I dodge a lot of the times, and I also have decent HP and HP recovery, so everything's working real well. Yeah, I'll try Assassin. It could be decent enough. I don't know how good it's going to be, but it might be really good, it might be really bad. I mean, it also helps trigger shatters more, right? So. Yeah, I'll go Sponger, that's fine. Do these bullets have the chance to inflict status effects? I mean, it looks like it. All, look at everything shattering. It's apparently really, really good. Don't mind getting this at all. Definitely more movement speed. Gives me a lot of defenses. It also, you know, gives me that burn. So now here's the problem is, well, there's far too few enemies and I'm really incompetent at dealing with them. The spread makes it really hard. Yes, give me more enemies to fight, that's what I need. Can deal with it much better this way. Give me more move speed. Ow. Wait, did I get hit? I think I did. I really hope I can deal with this spread soon. I don't want to grab that, but I also don't really have much of a choice. Gonna end up grabbing that on accident regardless, probably. Can't believe I don't even have Ice Shard yet. Yeah, this is tough. Tough to aim at anything specific. The only thing I can really aim is this fireball. What do you got for me? Kills damage equal to bullet damage? Okay. Increase fire at 10% for sword plus 1 for every 10. The spawn is reset upon getting hit. Sure. I'll take noise here. problem at all. They are not spawning enough enemies for me. It's usually a good sign the run's going well if I'm complaining there's not enough enemies. Can't really get any experience until you start giving them more to kill. There we go. That's better. I love how I just don't get hit, because like even if it looks like they're touching me, I'm just tiny, so I don't ever get hit for real. Or I dodge everything. Splitfire is alright. I'll get piercing as well. Splitfire would be good because it's kind of an extra projectile, but I want like actual extra projectiles. Not just it shoots behind me. I want something that will help deal with the spread issue mostly. I'll go for it. Mostly for the damage. I don't think the bullet speed matters at all. Like, our bullet speed is plenty fast. I guess it helps a bit because we have piercing. Yeah, there's nothing to worry about here, is there? Completely neglected to give me any plus projectiles. Come on, give me experience. It's so hard to not dodge at this point with how much move speed I have. Bullet size could help. See, this is annoying. Most of my effectiveness comes from having a lot of enemies to fight at once, and now if I'm just fighting you, it's not gonna be as effective. Wait, you dash too? Calm down. When's the last time I've actually taken damage? Like, I dodge everything, apparently. Be careful. Can't exactly hit easily, like, the angle is so awkward. Okay, having some more enemy spawn should help with this. But I need smaller enemies to spawn. This angle is pretty tough. There we go. More enemies means hopefully we'll be better off. They really don't want me to get anything here. Oh. I'll go for this. They really don't want any extra projectiles. I mean, we're able to just get through this run with pretty much only dodge. And that's been enough to get us through, it seems. Okay, fan fire will do, I guess. Those could be good. Bullet bounce, less bullet damage. Sure, I'll go for it. Should hopefully get more frozen enemies this way. How many dodges in a row I get? My movement speed is just too good. Dodge rate just goes through the roof with all of the move speed. Okay, split fire. It's at least kind of a thing. Oh, it looks like it actually chains into other projectile bonuses as well. I feel like I dodged like 6 attacks in a row. Is that accurate? Oh, did I actually take damage? I like took damage for real that time. That's crazy. This guy shouldn't have any problem dying. Sure. That won't be a problem at all. Shoots out 3 bullets to do 50% damage? Yeah, sure, whatever. My black holes are not particularly something I'm paying much attention to at the moment. It's kind of just a nice bonus effect at this point. Yeah, give me more projectiles. Finally. See, when you have 3 projectiles, this huge spread doesn't matter because it splits at least in the middle. Although I have more than 3 now. We've got 4. Plus the one in the back. See, if I had this, like, much sooner, yeah. Okay, so split fire actually, like, chains into that, and I didn't realize that, so that would have helped a lot. If I had paid any attention, I guess. Not that it mattered, like, the run went very smoothly regardless. Dodge is too strong, apparently. It's not even just dodge, like I had the soul hearts as well. Well, I guess they were able to build as much because of dodge, so they pretty much was just dodge. Alright, let's try another one, perhaps. Let's see. Who do I want to try? We can try this one every 6 shots, so we could use this on dual SMGs. I could also use it on flame cannon. I think that could be good. I still haven't won a run with a crossbow, but we'll get to that. I think I want a sword upgrade. Which one will I take? Infinite piercing and double bullet size. 50th kill, ethereal state. That could be good. Exactly one summon gain. Let's go for Ethereal. Get a couple of those. So it's 4 seconds now. Elites move faster. Alright. Let's just do some forest. How about? Let's give this a try. It's kind of small range here. So I'm hoping to get some good synergies with Burn and Frozen early on. It doesn't have to be early, but yeah, it would be nice. Even more Frozen. Frost Mage here. Careful there. Yep, Electro Mage, of course. All of these just combo really well together, so why wouldn't I? Oh my gosh, the Ethereal State. Frostbite or Rapid Fire? We go Rapid Fire for now. I think it's a very strong upgrade. Be careful here, but we're mostly fine. Yeah, I think move speed. And go dodge later. Perhaps, but move speed first. Mostly, like, everything, like, moving faster makes this kind of necessary eventually, regardless, so. Well, I'm tempted by a lot of these things, but I really want double shot. Effects. Blazing speed, rubber bullets, how about? I feel like this gun just always ends up being strong regardless. Once you get some combos and stuff, like get some more status effect, get some more speed on it, works out incredibly well. I think I'm becoming dodge-pilled here. That last run really showed me how good it can be. I already thought it was good, but now, like, at this point, I'm like, maybe it's, like, really, really good. Got some fanfire. And just nothing has a chance. No shot at all. What does this character give me? Double how often Frostbite effect freezes or damages nearby enemies. Okay. Seems good to me. Tiny. Just has no shot. Can't do anything. Yeah, go Pyromage. Even more burn. And of course, it'll allow us to get some extra burn damage later on in the tree. Like we're gonna get another flamethrower run for sure. And already it's getting close. They just have no shot. They can't do anything at all. Almost next level. There we go. Yeah, I go Ice Shard. I usually don't see the need in Siege, it's just standing still doesn't matter too much unless a lot more enemies spawn. And then I could stand still without Ethereal. Look how easy this shit is. They have no chance. Bullet damage. See, like, normally I'm getting so many builds that, like, bullet damage isn't really what I want. If I was, like, crossbow, like, maybe. Honestly, okay, look. We go move speed. And we get the dodge upgrade. And we're never going to take damage again. It's never happening. What are they gonna do? They're gonna go through all of our dodge percentage. Somehow doubt it. Plus they have to get to us in the first place. I mean, we're pretty strong regardless. The thing with Siege is it's already like the last part of the tree, so it's not even like comboing into anything that would be good. Don't get me wrong, I don't think it's a bad upgrade. It's not what I'm saying. Just often not what I want. There are situations where it could be better. But the enemies still aren't even close enough to us most of the time. Your dodge is increased by move speed, finally. Now I can be real comfortable. See, at this point it feels like maybe standing still is more feasible. Yeah, more fireballs. Got lots of them, let's get more. It was just straight up pushing up against me. Never had a chance to do anything. We'll call this as well. Just to be extra safe. and we'll be able to accumulate those hearts quite easily with our dodge chance. Again though, they're not even getting close to me. I normally find soul conversion to be pretty unnecessary. If you're not getting hit long enough to be making use of it, you're probably perfectly fine on your health regardless, so. If you have other synergies, it can be good though. That was a bit of a mistake. Yeah, running gun's gonna help a lot here. See, that mistake wouldn't have happened if I had running gun to begin with. I got that 500th enemy very quickly there. They have no chance. Shot at all. Blazing speed, sure. Look how ridiculous this is. My goodness. What do I grab? Electro bug. I want to get the last, like, the extra lightning damage. I think that might be necessary for the, like, explosion combo, but I'm not sure. I don't exactly know what causes them to show up, or if it's just random, or if you need, like, a combination of, like, completed trees. Okay. This is definitely something I want. Sure. As if I didn't have enough dodge chance, let's get even more move speed. This is a boss comp. I don't actually know, like, the timers. Or elite. I still don't know the difference between bosses and elites, or if there is a difference or whatever. Reload rate, fire rate, bullet damage, soothing warmth. I'm gonna grab this because I want to see if I need to complete this tree. And maybe that'll make the explosions show up. Although, even if it does show up, that's not proof that that's what I need. Although if it shows up immediately on the next level, it's at least an argument that it might be the case. What if it doesn't, then I have no clue. You wanna spawn these guys a little faster for me? Would be a real big help. Guy's gonna die quickly. He has no chance. I can't imagine not dodging, right? Frozen enemies take 30% extra damage. That's not gonna be a problem at all. Wait, I actually took damage. What? Hold on, give me siege. Give me siege. Problem is, I still have to move because of the projectiles. Yeah, there's not quite enough of them still. Oh, too many projectile enemies. Come on now. Kind of proving my point here that I can't really make good use of it. What do we got here? Splitfire, that's gonna be good. Look how many enemies there are. This is nice. Love when this happens. It seems doesn't work because they all get frozen, even with a lot of enemies. Give me experience. I want my levels. That's a lot of minus move speed, what the heck? It's fine, we don't need to dodge as much anymore because, well, look at all these soul hearts and look at all this damage. It feels like once you get to a state like this where the run gets very easy. I mean, it's just completely free, obviously, but like, it's funny how a lot of the time, like, it can be really tough, and then if you just get the right upgrades instead, it's like not tough in the slightest, but sometimes you just don't get the right upgrades, I guess. And sometimes you just like get really good upgrades in a row, like early on, and then a run that is just never a problem at all. Let's go Electro Mastery. This is what I've been waiting for. Surely this guy just dies fast, right? Ow. There. Okay. You guys gotta go. You're annoying me. Obviously, we're taking this one. Stop shooting so many projectiles. Get out of here. Why is every single enemy one of you. Surely you're not gonna last very long. I mean, look at this. There's no way you last long when this is your situation. Yeah, I think you do need to get them maxed, because now I have them both maxed, and then it finally showed up. Yeah, I don't think that's really gonna matter all that much. I hardly even notice these butterflies exist. I do enough frost on my own, let's be honest. I'll take some energized as well. Now my ammo just actually lasts forever, pretty much, it seems. What do you even go for here? Magnetism? Honestly, who cares about much else here? All those other upgrades aren't all that important. Sure, I'll go magic scythe, why not? It's not gonna do anything for me. Nothing has any chance at all. It's all doomed. I'll take Wither. Even more bonus damage. But I already had like bonus damage against frosted enemies, right? Frozen enemies, I guess. That's how you would say that, not frosted. They got no shot. I'm surprised how quickly we made this run work, though. Like, we just picked up the character and we did it. No problem at all. I mean, honestly, like, none of this matters. None of this is any use. Run is almost done. I don't know, just give me something. It doesn't matter. I have less than a minute left here. I think even tiny alone, like just having smaller character sizes, better than it might seem on paper. Like, it's actually really effective. None of this matters. Just grab something. Alright, that's gonna do it for this one, isn't it now? Just another second there, and we're done. we earned a lot there. We can unlock our last character, Dasher, and then kind of just continue upgrading this as much as possible. But yeah, that's gonna do it for this one. If you enjoyed the video, consider subscribing. Until next time, thanks for watching.